All right, time to get season three kicked off. Tulane Green Wave. Home opener, season opener, come in at number 8.
Hi everybody, Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. In downtown
yes.
Atlanta, Bobby
yes, we
Dodd
were.
Stadium, the site for today's showdown. An intimate place to play a college football game, one where the fans are right on top of you. That will only add to the intensity of
Randy Moss, the running
today.
Game's best friend.
We've done all we can do here. Time to tee it up. Let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for the call. David and I will be with you at halftime.
Matt Bowen's a cool guy to chat with. Alright, season three. Will this be the year that we break through?
Bobby Dodd Stadium isn't the biggest stadium around, but when the fans get it going here, it's as raucous as they come. Football is on the way. And that's time for the coin toss. And it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Georgia Tech will be kicking off, and you can just feel the energy in the air.
And away we go. Season three is underway.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Randy Moss better than Calvin Johnson? Yes.
The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game.
I mean, you got to remove the a-hole factor out of the equation and just judge them by just sheer ability and impact on the game. Moss is better. Moss, best receiver I've seen since Jerry Rice.
From their own 26-yard line, second down. Tackles him hard at the 27-yard line.
Wow, only gained 1 yard out of that. I like that. I like that a lot. Wow.
Fires out.
He got open.
And down he goes at about the 49. A nice looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
First and 10. Ball on their own 49.
Moss could go over the middle. I never felt that was a weakness in his game. I don't think Moss had a weakness other than sometimes being in the mood at the try.
Hey. catch it. He's got nowhere to go.
Let's get him off the field on third down this time, please.
And they'll look to convert here on another third down. He throws.
Wow.
He's knocked out of bounds.
That was a hell of a play.
From the 24-yard line, it's first down. He might be coming here. Tackle made at the 27. Loss of about three on the toss play.
All right, come on. It's freaking Tulane.
From the 27-yard line, it's second down. And they make the stop around the 17-yard line. Play number nine of this current drive.
There we go. Get him down. Thank you.
Pushed out of bounds at the 14-yard line.
Just overall flexibility, Mr. Drew.
Usually you get a linebacker covering.
I feel like the 3-3-5 stack offers you a lot of answers versus, you know, every type of spread that you could see. Timeout just to kick a field goal. Cowards! Pick us up, it's good.
And the field goal is good. Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
The Hurricanes were ranked 23rd. The victory was solid. We'll see how much it impresses the voters.
And for Kyle Olsen, what a washout he turned out to be.
A touchdown reception in this game. Miami cruises to an easy victory. In other games, the Cardinals came into the day ranked 12th. All those who said they weren't.
Look at the Irish ranked number one.
Plenty of ammunition. And for Notre Dame,
that's what I like to see.
Carlisle throttle was stuck on wide open as he barreled into the end zone for a touchdown. The Fighting Irish win the game 34-31.
Reese, 3-0 here.
Yes, and it can hold its own against a pro-style offense as well. You just got to use a lot of 3-3-5, 5 LBs, and Oki, 3-4 set, as well as the Bear.
Irons from the two. Across the 30.
Let's
and
go.
Comes in to make the tackle. Lee's overall ability, Herbie, got to drive you crazy for defensive coach.
Yeah, you look at a defensive coordinator trying to slow this guy down. It's next to impossible. He can do so many different things, and today they're going to try to put pressure on him because if you sit
all right
back, he can
do, offense's
he just
turn.
Makes too many things happen.
So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field.
Don't really have a great fullback. We kind of got to play this by committee. Wow, someone missed a block completely.
Bring him down at the 49. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 49-yard line.
tackle
right around the 50.
Hey, we gotta have a warm-up game, Mr. Bird. I threw that too soon. What am I doing?
He has to make better decisions than that. He should have known that there was no room to squeeze that ball in there.
That was dumb.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line. Tulane has a three-point lead. Steps out of bounds around the 45-yard line.
Right now, Tulane's doing some stuff.
Fires it out. Down at the 46.
Here's the true test of a quarterback at any level. Can they make a good throw under pressure when one or two or three guys are coming right at him? I think this young passer has proven that.
Well, there is no 5LB 335 set in Madden. There's no 335 stack set in Madden at all. There we go. There's a 335 nickel, which is just a nickel subset.
And he's taken down at the 36. A good play fake that time.
Here, the play action was key. It held the linebackers there by the fake by the running back, and the running back did a very nice job of carrying out his fake.
From the 36-yard line, first down. Jumped out of bounds at the 38-yard line.
No, it's different. A 335 nickel normal is three linebackers, a nickel corner instead of a safety, and two safeties.
Second down. Tulane holds a field goal lead. Throws it away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Here's the eighth play of the series.
There we go.
And he hits him hard at the 46-yard line.
Bo Hankins storms in and gets the sack.
The sack makes this a
right, exactly. If you want to play that book that way.
He doesn't want a touchback here. He wants to knock this ball inside the 10. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. Their last drive ended with an interception. We're about to find out what the defense can do this time.
This quarterback can make good passes. He just needs to focus on not forcing the ball to his receivers.
There we go.
Around the 28-yard line.
Roderick Snoddy has to be my St. John days this season. Half running back, half slot receiver. Out of slot back spots.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line.
Ty Griffin, he gets his first playing time. He's a redshirt freshman.
First and 10. Ball on the 30. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Travis Custis is a converted slot back who's playing fullback now. Wow. That got blown up.
Georgia Tech's got a guy behind center that can really do it all, Herbie. I mean, he's a dual threat. He can hurt you with his feet and his arm. With this guy, it's PYP. Pick your poison. Third down and 6 yards to go. Ball on the 34.
All right, let's go. That's better.
Around the 46-yard line.
What the barn that time.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 46.
Well, the problem is the fullbacks aren't good ball carriers. The ones that are generated, they're either blockers or receivers. Here's the beauty of these pistol flexbone sets. I can just audible to a flexbone set and have the same personnel.
Nice gain as he works the right side.
What is going on with his defense? I mean, don't get me wrong, the offense is doing a nice job with first downs and they're executing well, but the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field.
All right, sloppy first quarter. Yeah, BJ, that's really the best way to do it. I think. Look, I have a quarterback who I'm redshirting who could have played fullback if he didn't have, you know, throwing ratings in the 80s. But the fullbacks are almost mini tight ends. Blocking over there, really nice.
Gains his way to the 23-yard line. Set to resume action here in the second quarter. We've got a tight ball game. Makes his way out to about the 15. And this is the 10th play of the drive.
This is a fullback give all the way.
Run up the middle.
If I had a real fullback there, he probably trucks that guy.
from the 11-yard line. First down. Got the corner.
But he can do that. Oh, how's he not in?
They tried to put together what they think is going to put them in a position to be able to slow down this offense. That's the sixth first down on this drive alone. Now they got a confused defense and a tired defense on this drive. They better hope somehow that they're able to hold this offense to a field goal. But it's not looking good right now.
They're crowding the line.
There we go. All right, we get our first touchdown of the season.
These blocking backs do a lot of dirty work during the game, so it's good to reward them. Let them barrel it in for a score once in a while.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. It was a 12-play, 79-yard drive, and the result, 7 points.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running backs.
Georgia Tech is ready to kick it away. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. On the draw play.
Oof, he got punked. Jeez.
And they get nice yardage on that run. From their own 29-yard line, it's second down. Brought down in the open field.
This guy's slinging it, son.
Yards and a first down.
It's the protection up front that allowed this play to happen. The line controlled the rush, and it gave the quarterback an opportunity to deliver a very nice throw.
Sit down, buddy.
He's down. To get the first here on second down.
I missed, thought I had that jumped.
At the 49-yard line. First down. Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
Yeah, a lot of the obscure and smaller and bad schools have really good playbooks, but they're crap obscure teams.
From the 28-yard line, first down. And
Not sure what he was doing. He was just kind of tiptoeing around the tulips.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. They'll spread the field with 5 wide.
Now he tries to buy some time. Oh.
He's at the 20.
Got some good wheels.
And he's down.
Okay. Starting to try to play a little bit here.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 17-yard line. Again with a carry. And they hit it in the backfield.
Good job by the defense to overpower the offensive line and drop the back for a loss.
They're doing a good job against the ground attack.
10th play of the drive.
Giving up too many completions for my liking, though. Bust out the zone read, and they're going to score. Wow.
Yeah, green wave. Trying to go up by 3. They'll kick the extra point. And he hits the PAT. The
best way to defend the flood plays is to defend the slot receiver and make people go short every single time. Or user the slot, user the defender covering the slot receiver or tight end.
Tulane lines up for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. Each of the 10. They'll bring him down at the 15-yard line.
Now, this has been a great game to watch. A lot of competitive spirit out there. The offenses seem to be going up and down the field. Back and forth we go. I think the winner will be which defense can make that pivotal stop to secure a victory.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes.
Ah, come on now, guys. Block.
The 13-yard line. That'll bring up second and 12. It's second down, 12 to go. Ball on the 13.
There you go, Fad.
So the quarterback keeps it for about 7 yards. Third down, 5 yards to go. Ball on the 20-yard line.
There's my redshirt freshman speedster. Don't go, Fad. Ah, damn it.
They bring the quarterback down.
Fred, 180.
nice run there as they work the outside. 6 yards there on the option keeper.
Sloppy.
Secondary really get after it and can make life hard for the play callers on the other side of the ball.
They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. Oh, excellent punt. Signals for a fair catch.
Yes, it is.
Maybe being a nail biter.
Yeah, this game just feels like it's going to go well into the second half, probably into the fourth quarter. You almost have a feel that maybe one of the defenses may have to score a touchdown to be able to win this game.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Tulane has a three-point lead. Catches it, and he's looking for more. Brought down around the 26-yard line. London picks up 6 yards with that grab. Tulane
Jeez,
is going to use
14
their first
for 16.
Time out of the half here.
Not good.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. He's scrambling. And they make the stop at the 29.
All right, that we got to cut out. We flushed them, but someone's got to be there.
Away from picking up the first down. Their second time out of the half.
Good old Cordell. I remember Cordell. I think you're right about that, Bird. You've seen Terrell Pryor has finally embraced playing wide receiver. You should have done that 3 years ago.
And he's taken down. Midfield. Tulane holds a field goal lead.
There we go.
He's wrapped up for the sack.
Jabari Hunt Days gets his first sack of the season.
The defender did everything that he needs to do. He read the play perfectly. He stepped up, and what does he do? Drops the interception. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
So another third down here, and this time it's third and long. He's going to go for the home run.
There we go.
The defender had it and then dropped it.
Mary time.
One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw one towards the end zone here. Pass incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver. Defensive dominance through two quarters of play. We go to halftime. 10-7.
Yeah, I'll consider a flood a triangle concept. Triangle concepts tend to have a more West Coast and air raid connotation to it, but yeah, flood counts.
Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. He's Davis, David Pollack here in the
right now. I'm losing 10-7 at the half to Tulane.
What just went down in the first 30 minutes? One thing has been apparent in this first half that we just saw. Both defensive coordinators a step ahead of their counterparts on offense. They've had the answer for every formation, every shift, every movement, every motion that they tried to come up with. So, to try to break free and get something moving on offense.
Gotta snap out of this in a hurry.
A little trickeration.
A little trickeration never hurt nobody. I mean, it's something that if you keep doing what you've been doing, you're gonna keep getting what you've been getting. And you gotta find a way to do something a little bit different because it wasn't working. Let's find some new plays in that book. Let's run a little bit of option. Let's run it the reverse. Let's run some double passes. How about we bring a blitz with everybody? Just don't even cover anybody. Just bring everybody. Bring the house. You know, try to do something a little bit out of the ordinary. Try to get a spark going for your ball club.
That's going to do it at halftime. Just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, bro. I'm going to get something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
Great first half. Hopefully the second half's as good. He just drills this one.
Let's march this bad boy down the field, please.
Tackle at the 19.
Brad, everywhere we go and we travel all over the country, people want to talk about offense. Oh, the spread or the pistol. Hurry up, tempo offense and points. It's nice to watch a team that prides itself on playing great defense. And when it's all said and done, the teams that advance and get to the important bowl games and do well in the postseason are teams that have this kind of defense.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
I got tripped up. Dang it, that a big hole. I just got tripped up trying to go through it.
Second down and six. Ball on their own 23.
Okay.
So that's a 7-yard run there for the running back.
Good decision making that time on the option. He read the defense perfectly and was able to make a good pitch.
Yeah, Tulane doesn't exactly draw people, do they? Oh, why'd you go? Oh, and Vad will still house it. That was just Vad's greatness there because a slot back blocked the wrong dude. Let's go.
And he converts the extra point. Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
The Terrapins were ranked 11th in the nation. They hope that spot proves they are capable of rising much higher. And for Maryland, they grab a W in the season opener.
They line up to kick this one away. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Yeah, there's no difference in the game as far as recruiting with the service academies and recruiting with anybody else.
Thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Caught out of the open.
Okay.
Right around the 30. We've got a second and five. Ball on the 30-yard line. It out to maybe the
come on, off the field. That's true, Bird. You don't see too many 6'7", 310 pounders at the academies.
taken down around the 47-yard line. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Dove too soon. Dove too soon.
Good decision there by the quarterback.
From their own 47-yard line, it's first down.
Jeez.
And he's tackled at the 45-yard line. That makes it second and two. Runs it right. Nice pickup. The 39-yard line. First down.
Go, let's go! Yeah.
Oh, come on now.
For a nice run.
Let's not start giving up yards on the ground all of a sudden. And they're on the march again.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 27.
There we go. Who got in there? Patrick Gamble gets in there for his first sack of the season. Someone just whiffed on the block.
It's the ninth play of the drive.
Wow.
Tackle made at about the 23-yard line.
That'll bring up third and six.
And once again, they'll come to the line trying to convert on third down. Fires out to his receiver.
Jeez.
A huge play, and now they're in a great position.
Well, add him to the all-name team. Fudge Van Hooser.
That makes it first and goal.
It's first down.
What the hell kind of name is that?
Again with the run, and he makes it out to about the 5-yard line. We're at the 12th play of the drive.
I gotta put a spy on this dude. Robbins is the steroid user.
Zips it to
good
the
tackle.
Back. They'll bring him down around the 4-yard line. Go. Third and goal from the 3-yard line.
Go, let's go.
No, does not get in on the speed option. Jabari Hunt Day's big tackle. So they're still hanging around.
He sends this one deep. He's to the 10. He's to the 20. He gets hit out of bounds at the 23. The Yellow Jackets have got to remember that they've still got a fight on their hands in this football.
Yeah, they cannot afford to get sloppy. Remember the first half, how bad they looked. And as good as things are going right now, with an entire quarter to go, they got to continue to play good football.
So their last drive resulted in 6 points. Do you think we'll
no, Nick Montana's gone. Who was there last season?
Really well on their last drive. And until this defense figures out how to stop it, I think they'll have no problem moving the ball down the field.
Now he pitches it, makes it to the 31. Second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Georgia Tech with a one-point lead. Makes it out to about the 39.
Yeah, the Montana jeans didn't run that deep, unfortunately. INT.
Yeah, the quarterback's breathing a huge sigh of relief because he got away with throwing what should have been an interception.
From their own 39-yard line, it's second down.
Blame Joe Montana 16. Be nice.
Tackles him for a loss. That makes it 11.
All right, I need a play here.
From their own 38-yard line.
Chris Sims had a decent college career.
First down pass to his tailback.
And Brian Irons gets his first career reception. Chris Sims actually got the Bucks to the playoffs 1 year.
Georgia Tech is up one.
All right, let's go, Vad.
At about the 29-yard line.
Yeah, Chris Simmons didn't do too badly for himself.
First and 10. Ball on the 29-yard line.
He just busted up his spleen, and that was the end of his career.
Up the middle for a nice game.
I believe Chris Simmons won a playoff game, if I'm not mistaken.
Number 8 on the drive.
Easy, 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 easy.
Bo Broderick.
Big play, and it's first and goal.
All right, this game is closer than I would like it to be.
Georgia Tech leads 14-13. Back to the action here. Tight ball game in the fourth quarter. And down he goes at about the 5-yard line.
Yeah, Brad Johnson was decent. Leave Brad alone.
From the 5-yard line, second down, Georgia Tech up a point. And they get nice yardage on that run.
Brad did what he was asked to do, which was not to screw up and get Warren Sapp and the rest of the defense mad at him.
And the goal line defense digging in here.
Whoa, wow.
The middle and stuffed.
You know what, I'm going for it.
The offense is staying on the field. It's all or nothing. Here we go.
And we're going to get it. System and organizational stability, Mr. Drew. I agree with that.
The defense on that one.
Boy, and that took some second effort against that goal line defense. And he adds the extra point. So a 12 play, 76-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance.
All right, let's go.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Let's get control of this damn game and not look back.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. He gets rid of
good start.
Great job by the defense in getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 25.
Whoa, whoa. Come on now, boys. He completed that?
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 36-yard line. Under heavy pressure.
There we go.
It's intercepted. He's taken
no more of that
right
back foot garbage.
And that is an absolutely huge turnover for this defense. They couldn't have picked that off at a better time.
Just a horrible decision by the quarterback trying to force that pass, especially at this point in the game.
And 10, ball on the 50. Georgia Tech holds an 8-point advantage.
Let's go. Now we're rolling.
To the 36-yard line.
quickly.
Damn it.
What is he thinking? The quarterback has got to know at this time in the game, unless his man is wide open, that he should just throw it away. It's these kinds of mistakes.
I was hoping for a better effort from my receiver than that. Howdy, D.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 21-yard line. He's going to try and scramble.
All righty.
They bring the quarterback down.
Starting to get overwhelmed by the pressure now.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long. He's tackled at the 20-yard line.
Yeah, Tavon Austin is on his way to Bustville pretty soon, Drew, if he doesn't snap out of it.
It's third and long, and at this stage of this game, they probably have to go to the air.
Ooh, a screen.
Sets up a screen.
But we get it. We read it.
The 19-yard line.
They want Tavon Austin to play like Stevie Smith, and he's not that kind of guy.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Georgia Tech up by 8. He gets out to about the 48-yard line.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 8.
Second and 8. Ball on the 48-yard line. He makes his way to about the 42.
All right, time for Vad to take this game over. Tavon Austin needs to be with a team that'll get the ball to him in space. He's not an outside receiver.
Box left, met behind the line.
That's a massive 10 yards on the play. That'll bring up 2nd and 11.
From the 43-yard line. Second down. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Third and 5. Ball on the 37. Less than 3 minutes in the game.
Go, Vad. Nice blocking. Really nice blocking.
Down of bounds at the 14-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 14. Nice run up the middle.
Brian Schottenheimer. Good God. How does Brian Schottenheimer keep on getting jobs? Is his family name that powerful?
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
Let's go, trap option. I'll take the late pitch. I mean, Brian Schottenheimer has to be one of the worst OCs in the league by a lot.
It shouldn't surprise these guys to see the run coming at them, but they just couldn't stop it.
Converts the extra point. Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
I mean, at least Shanahan's kid has a clue or two. But God.
And for Marshall, he scored a touchdown.
Brian Schottenheimer, my goodness.
In another game, you're always locked in on what's going on in the top 10. And for Oregon, they run the ball with attitude. A ground and pound attack that results in a touchdown.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. And he got all.
Oh my gosh, is he really?
And it goes into the end zone.
What's the over under for how long it'll take Mart Richt to take over the play calling?
Not a lot of success for this offense on their last trip out. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Now he's scrambling.
And away he goes. Only gains 3 yards.
Second down at 7 coming up here. Ball on the 28.
That's a good play.
Made a nice catch.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 46.
Ah, how'd I miss?
He's tackled around the 18-yard line.
This is what happens when a quarterback and a receiver forge a good connection. They trust each other. And even though that looked like a risky pass, I'm sure they both knew that it could work out.
Gets it to his wide receiver. Jeez. He's got another one. Nice play to set up first and goal. That makes it first and goal. First and goal, and they'd love to get into the end zone and make this a game again. Five wide. Fires quickly.
Good gosh, you believe this? And they will go for two.
So the offense is going to go for two. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Caught it, and the conversion is good.
And they are only down 7.
And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some...
Yeah, I know. I saw his game. I'm having a heck of a time with friggin' Tulane. What the hell gives?
They're running down at the 35. Tulane's going to have to use their second time out of the half. Short yardage situation here. Second down and one.
That's a great job by this offense. The defense knew that the run was coming, and they still could not slow them down. Pick up a first down and allows them to continue to work this clock.
From the 30,
I guess.
It's first down. It's second down now, 13 to go. Ball on the 34. Under a minute left in the game. And he is drilled at the 35-yard line.
We have no timeouts left. Let's just take a knee and get out of here. Move on to the next game. This was just terrible.
The quarterback takes a knee, and that's always a good sign if you're a fan of this team.
All right, we win, but we did not win pretty. Not in the least. Yeah, that's good news, Mr. D.
Goodbye, and we'll see you next time.